In my memorabilia, I have a picture of the old church. It was quite different than this is. I have a lot of memories of attending Sunday school and riding to church in a school bus.
It had a very active young people's group, and we always had Sunday night services where they would have hymn sings.
It was a very large, thriving church with a lot of programs. But over the years, people just began drifting away. We had some attrition due to people moving away. There were some difficulties with personal relationships, as often happens in churches. And we just got to the point after a while that we were doing so many programs and trying so hard to continue to do what we always had done that the church was in serious decline.
When we first arrived at Manoa, we were really warmly welcomed by the church. The very first week that Stefan started was VBS week, so we ended up volunteering, and it was wild because we had just moved.
Where I said, I'm happy to serve wherever y'all need me. So they put me with the three-year-old boys. Fortunately, they didn't call me to be the children's director. They called me to be the pastor.
When Stefan arrived here, he had the mantra, let's do less better. Certain services that the church had always done, certain activities that the church had thrown itself into had dwindled to about 3 to 5 people would show up at these things. We had to stop to really focus on the things that the Lord was calling us to.
It really gave all of us a breath of fresh air. I think a lot of us had been overwhelmed.
Stefan came with such a vision of growth in the children's ministry and music ministry and evangelism. They were his main things.
When we got here, there were very few children. So I have 4 children, Stefan had 4 children. Some Sundays, 8 was our children's ministry. And we've seen a wonderful transformation. We called it Kingdom Kids and just tried to energize and bring a lot of vitality to the children's ministry.
To have a real genuine faith, to have a changed heart, right? And to bring that into their families, to their friends at school, and to bring that beyond this town, even to the uttermost parts of the earth, as the scripture states. That is what I desire. I'm sure that is what Stefan, that is what everyone on staff, that is what the parents want.
My kids get to be part of the children's ministry, that they get to be around kids, that they develop this heart to love children and to care for children, to be around all ages, like royal students, youth group, people my age in my small group, and they see us gathering and coming over.
I love the generational diversity of the church. As we continue to get older in the church, we're still finding opportunities for fellowship as Christians to continue to grow.
Bringing on Esty and Priscilla has just been so amazing to see how God's grown the music ministry here, and having more musicians, having more singers, having opportunities for even the choir to sing during our Easter service.
It's grown so much, not just in number, I think, but also in engagement and spirituality. And it's just been awesome to see that change over the past 2 years. And I don't think any of us really expected it just to happen so quickly.
The music is always speaking to my heart. It's always singing about my situation. And it's always revealing the might of Christ to me.
Just to hear the joy and the worship and the praise was just all-encompassing. I don't think we would have had that a couple of years ago.
They were ready to do church and hear the word preached, but to actually reach this community for Christ and believe that this church could turn around. I had to share my faith with people until they could get excited again.
No sugarcoating it, we're not getting out cotton candy. We are being faithful to the word of God.
You ain't gotta be bound anymore. You are free in Jesus. He got the power to loose you and break every chain, to rip every rope off of you. Woo! Somebody needs to receive that this morning.
The only thing that matters is that you had life and you had it abundantly, and you had it in Christ Jesus, and you have it for all eternity. Amen? It's all that matters.
This is a church giving to evangelism, giving to mission. I'm like, wow, this is it. So not that just preaching Jesus, but also taking the message of Jesus out. This is home.
Pews are no longer empty, so that's great, right? And our family is expanding. That's how we feel about the growth at Manoa.
Like, Manoa is a family, and it just keeps on growing.
I feel there's a sense of expansion here and excitement.
Yeah, and a real passion for what they're doing. Pastor Stefan and Pastor Ron, their spirit is contagious.
It's diverse with people from various walks of life, different cultures, all on the same mission.
It represents the community that we live in, and it's what heaven will be like. That was something that was important to us as we were looking for a church.
Inasmuch as Jesus Christ has been lifted up, God is going to use Manoa to draw men and men unto Him. It's a beautiful church, so the future is bright.
I believe in church revitalization just as strongly as I believe in church planting, and that there are many churches all over this country that we need the next generation of leadership to rise up and step in to these amazing churches with people who are left with a heart of gold. They're not there because it's the coolest church on the block right now. They're not there because they have the best music and the best whatever. They're there because they love each other, they love Jesus, and they believe in the gospel. And that's the heart of Manoa.